I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this lesson, we're going to take a look at the best way to use noise reduction in DaVinci Resolve. Now, if you have the full version of DaVinci Resolve, there is built-in noise reduction you can get to by opening up the Motion Effects palette. And noise reduction is controllable via two sets of parameters. There's spatial noise reduction and temporal noise reduction. Here's the thing. The way the controls are laid out, you'd think you probably want to start using spatial noise reduction and then add temporal noise reduction. And this, in fact, is precisely the opposite of what you ought to do for the best results, in my opinion. So I have this shot, and I've kind of artificially boosted the levels just to make a point. I'm going to go into enhanced viewer mode, and I'm going to actually create a new node to do my noise reduction within first. And I'm going to zoom in. Just so you can see as I play through, there's plenty of noise here for me to experiment on. So, with this setup, in my view, the best way to work is to start out by adding temporal noise reduction. You can choose one or two frames to compare for DaVinci Resolve's algorithm to try and determine which parts of the frame are noise and which part are legitimate image detail. And then you can choose a motion estimation type. I'm just going to choose better for now. And you can choose a motion range. Now, she's not moving really fast, but she's not moving really slow, so I think medium is probably the best. And at this point, I can raise Luma. And if I press Command D to just turn the current node off and on, you can see that this setting is doing a really good job of getting the noise out without softening image detail. And that's the magic of temporal noise reduction. It's actually the least destructive of the two methods of noise reduction that Resolve makes available. It's computationally intensive, but it does a really good job. Now, of course, you also want to bear in mind that it does its best work on parts of the image that aren't in motion, just by the nature of how temporal noise reduction works. So having done most of the noise reduction with temporal noise reduction, now we can move back into spatial noise reduction controls to kind of finish the job using controls that are much more effective even when parts of the image are in motion. But because we've done a lot of work with temporal noise reduction, we shouldn't need to add much spatial noise reduction at all. So if I just raise this just a little tiny bit, you can see that now I have a much cleaner image without sacrificing much image detail at all. So I do a before, after of just that adjustment. You can see that this softens the image little teeny tiny amount, but not that much. And frankly, I could probably drop the threshold a little bit more. Now, in situations where you've got more chroma speckling than noise in Luma, you can actually click this link button to decouple these controls, and you can then increase chroma, which you can get away with because people aren't going to notice things happening to chroma as much as they're going to notice things happening to Luma. And that can give you an additional edge in your noise reduction without cranking visible artifacts up to 11. And again, if I press play, you can see that I've got a really nice result here. And I really haven't pumped these settings up all that high. So that's my big tip, is start with temporal noise reduction before applying spatial noise reduction. Because if you apply spatial noise reduction first, you'll be tempted to add more, and that's not going to give you as clean a result. So I hope this has been helpful. If you want more information about this and all of grading in DaVinci Resolve, check out my titles available from rippletraining.com. I'm Alexis Van Hurkman. Thanks for watching.